gather this morning in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May the grace and peace of God our Father and our Lord Jesus Christ be with all of you. Welcome, everyone, as we begin this day at the table of the Lord, in the midst of rain and storm, and yet with the hope that the sun will continue to shine and bring life to our lives. Today we celebrate with the Church the feast of St. Lawrence, a great martyr in the early church, a Roman martyr who was a deacon, and a deacon who gave his life for the church in a very difficult way. It certainly inspires the church throughout the world continually to this day. So let us put ourselves in the presence of the Lord. That God would use us to inspire others to lead lives that truly grow in His love. Lord Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy. You come in word and in sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy. You will come again in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let's give glory to God. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, giver of that ardor of love for you, by which St. Lawrence was outstandingly faithful in service and glorious in martyrdom, grant that we may love what he loved, put into practice what he taught. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and whoever sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. Each must do as already determined, without sadness or compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. Moreover, God is able to make every grace abundant for you, so that in all things, always having all you need, you may have an abundance for every good work. As it is written, he scatters abroad, he gives to the poor, his righteousness endures forever. The one who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food will supply and multiply your seed and increase the harvest of your righteousness. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Blessed the man who is gracious and lends to those in need.
Blessed is the man who is gracious and lends to those in need.
Blessed the man who fears the Lord, who greatly delights in his commands. His posterity shall be mighty upon the earth. The upright generation shall be blessed.
Blessed is the man who is gracious and lends to those in need.
Well for the man
Literally, God only knows how many martyrs there are in heaven. And they each have their own unique story. But basically, they are the people whose faith was so strong that they were willing to give their lives for the Lord. We know some of them. There are books written that tell the stories of many of them. Martyrologies, they're called. And sometimes we kind of cling to one or another for whatever reason. The story of St. Lawrence is one of the more popular ones. Certainly affected Rome tremendously. With Peter and Paul, he's a patron of Rome and continues to be just a great saint in the church. And in his time, in the third century, there was a lot of political unrest and certainly reform in the church. And sometimes when you stand up for what's right and try to make changes, you pay a price, and he did. But the story is that a particular form of martyrdom was that he was roasted on a gridiron. Rather graphic. Picture. And not only that, I mean, that has to be very torturous, but he was a man who died with apparently joy in his heart. Sometimes these stories, there's a certain amount of things that get added to it, you don't know for sure, but one of the things that got added to it is that he told his torturers, okay, I'm done on this side, you can turn me over now. So I'm wondering, who's your favorite martyr? What's the story that most touches your heart? And my hope is this. I hope that none of us get roasted on a gridiron first. But if we really believe a martyr is one whose faith is so strong, that he or she is willing to give his life for the Lord, then it doesn't have to be on a gridiron or some of the graphic ways that we've heard the stories of the martyrs. It may just be the day-to-day ways that we give of ourselves, that we put ourselves last and the Lord first, that we're willing to make sacrifices of giving, witnessing, things that don't take our own gain into consideration, but rather, how will faith grow? How will the church grow? How will Christ grow in others? Corinth found joy because he knew God would provide for all his needs, so let us too trust in the loving care of our God. We pray for the church throughout the world that we will be a model of Christ-like living and Christ-like loving. We pray to the Lord. We pray for our community, for the safety and well-being and good health of all of our parishioners. We pray for wisdom for all of our leaders. We pray that we together as a community will be willing to really think about the good of others first and make sacrifices that enable their faith to grow. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all those who are sick, suffering, broken, grieved, those who are going through difficult times, those who've lost hope, those who just need someone to genuinely care about them, we pray to the Lord. We pray for people who sacrifice so much for us, people who continually just give of themselves for our good and for the good of our own faith, we pray to the Lord. We pray that God will always protect and bless all our children, our young adults, our children with special needs. Praise the Lord. We remember all those who have gone before us, all our own departed loved ones, friends, and parishioners, especially today for Dick and Marcy Vaughn, their family. We praise the Lord. Loving God, we give you our simple gifts, but most importantly, we give you our entire lives. Use them for your purpose so that faith in you and your kingdom may continue to grow. We ask all this through Christ our Lord. Let's bring our simple gifts. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For through your goodness we receive the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, the work of human hands, that will become for us the bread of life. May the mystery of this water and wine may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For through your goodness we receive the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, that will become our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Lord, wash away my iniquities and cleanse me. My sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours will be pleasing and acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Lord, accept the sacrifice in our hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Receive with favor, O Lord, the offerings we joyfully make on the feast of St. Lawrence, and grant that they become a help to our salvation through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts, and let us give thanks to the Lord our God. is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the blood of your blessed martyr, Lawrence, poured out by Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear your witness through Christ our Lord. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks to you, held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Edward our Bishop, and all who serve your church. Remember Dick and Marcy Vaughn and all of our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. The Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on your sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. My friends, may the peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's show each other a sign of our unity and peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ keep us safe for eternal life. us pray. Nourished by these sacred gifts, we humbly implore you, Lord, that the homage of dutiful service which we render on the Feast of St. Lawrence may bring us an increase of your saving grace through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Thanks, everyone, for sharing in the celebration, for all the ways that you give of your lives for the Lord, for the good of the faith. May God continue to use you and renew you with his love. So have a really good day. I'm sure it's going to stop raining eventually, and just enjoy this day that God gives us. Go in peace, glorifying God by your lives. We're going to sing together number 591. Blessed.